Okay, let us now continue with the electrochemistry one. The formulas, various formulas used for solving the various competitive exams. Let us first see transport number. What is transport number? It is represented by T. It is the fraction of the total current carried by the ion. Okay. The transport number is given U plus plus U minus. Where U is the ionic mobility of the ion. Mobility of the ion. As mobility of the ion is higher, the current carried by the ion is higher. Therefore, there is a relation between molar conductance, conductivity of the ion, and infinite dilution is directly proportional to the ionic mobility. Okay, so lambda naught plus equal to the proportionality constant is Faraday constant, 1 Faraday 96,500 U plus. Therefore, it can be written as lambda, because U naught plus is directly proportional to lambda plus. Therefore, lambda plus lambda naught minus. Therefore, lambda naught plus, this is the molar conductance of the electrolyte at the infinite dilution. So we can calculate the transport number by using this formula. Similarly, for T minus, it will be U minus. Okay, so it will be U minus and it will be this. Okay, we can calculate the transport number by using this formula. What is ionic mobility? Ionic mobility is defined as the ionic velocity per unit potential gradient. Okay, ionic velocity divided by potential gradient is nothing but potential divided by distance. Potential is the unit V and distance is the unit of centimeter. Okay, now diffusion coefficient 2. Diffusion coefficient D. It is represented by D. Diffusion coefficient of the ion. Diffusion of the ion. See, diffusion of the ion is directly proportional to U. Many problems are asked based on these formulas, especially diffusion coefficient. Diffusion coefficient is directly proportional to the ionic mobility, and also as you increase the temperature, the ions move faster. Thermal energy, it depends upon the diffusion coefficient, depends upon the thermal energy. We have already discussed thermal energy is nothing but KT. Therefore, it is directly proportional to U, KT, divided by EZ, where E is the charge on the electron and Z is the charge on the ion. For example, aluminium, take aluminium ion, D plus aluminium ion, diffusion coefficient of the aluminium ion, then it will be the aluminium ion ionic mobility, and Boltzmann constant, where K is the Boltzmann constant, it is given by molar gas constant divided by N. And temperature, T is the temperature. As you increase the temperature, the diffusion ion increases, diffusion coefficient also increases. And E is the charge on the electron, 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ Coulomb, we have seen in the previous class. And Z is the charge. For example, Z equal to, for aluminium ion, Z equal to 3. Okay, plus 3. The charge on the ion. Okay, 1 electron volt is equal to 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ joule, and one electrical energy or electrical work, we know work is equal to force into distance according to classical mechanics. But in electrical energy, the electrical work or electrical energy is given by voltage EMF times coulomb of electricity fast. Okay, let us now Ostwald's dilution law. What is Ostwald dilution law? It is applicable only for weak electrolytes such as acetic acid or AgBr, etc. At dilute solution condition, the acetic acid, for example, is a weak acid. In the beginning, at T equal to 0, C is the concentration, moles per liter of acetic acid, and 0. There will be no acetate ion and H plus ion in the beginning. Once the equilibrium is established at equilibrium T, after some time, the equilibrium is established, then the constant rise will be 1 minus c into 1 minus alpha and c alpha, where alpha is the degree of dissociation, which is the degree of dissociation is defined as the fraction of the total fraction of the electrolyte that is dissociated. It is partially ionized, that is dissociated. As already we have seen, alpha can be calculated by using the formula lambda m, molar conductance of the electrolyte divided by the same molar conductance of the electrolyte at infinite dilution by using Kolmogorov's law. It is obtained, we have seen. Now, this let us apply the law of equilibrium, K equal to C alpha, the product of products divided by the product of reactant, therefore C alpha into C alpha, C 1 minus alpha, therefore C alpha square. And now alpha is only weakly dissociated, it is only partially dissociated, therefore alpha is very very less than 1. So less than 1, 0.009, for example, if you take then 1, it will be 1, therefore Ka equal to alpha square. So once you know, see concentration of the acid, you know that the concentration of the acid, we know alpha m is known. We know the alpha, the conductance of the weak electrolyte being measured from Kolmogorov's law is obtained. So what you can calculate the dissociation constant of acid, where K is the dissociation constant of the acid. Similarly, the dissociation constant of the weak base can also be calculated, or dissociation constant of the electrolyte, sparingly soluble salt, can also be calculated. Let us move to ionic strength, fourth one. Ionic strength is defined as the measure of electrical intensity of the electrolytic solution. As you will know, the ionic strength will affect the rate of the ionic reactions. You see in salt effects, primary salt effect, secondary salt effect, while you study the chemical kinetics. Okay, now how it is, ionic strength is very very important to calculate the activity coefficient. We will see in the next. So what is, how the ionic strength is calculated? This is very important to obtain the mean activity coefficient. Okay, I equal to 1 by 2 summation of Ci Zi whole square. For example, where Ci is the concentration or modality of the solution, Zi is the charge of the ion. As I said, charge of the ion Z equal to 3 plus 3. For example, you have 0.1 molar or 1 molar calcium chloride solution. Okay. So calcium chloride is completely dissociated to give calcium Ca2 plus Cl minus. Okay. Therefore, 0.1 will be calcium ion concentration 0.1 molar. Okay. Whereas chlorine 0.2, 2 into 0.1, therefore 2 molar. Okay. Now, if you substitute in this expression, for example, 1 by 2 concentration of calcium ion. Concentration of calcium ion is 0.1, okay, into Z, charge on the calcium ion, therefore charge on the calcium ion is 2, therefore 2 square, plus concentration of the chloride ion, is 0.2 molar into charge on the minus 1, therefore minus 1 whole square will be 1 minus 1. Whole square, it will be always positive. It will be always, since we square negative, it will become positive. This is, therefore, we can calculate equal to 1 by 2, 0.1 into 4 plus 0.1 into 1, 1 square, 1. Therefore, this is, thus, the ion strength. For example, if you have a mixture of, for example, you have a sea water. Several electrolytes are present, for example calcium chloride. A solution consists of 0.1 molar calcium chloride and 0.12 molar sodium chloride. Then we have to add sodium chloride again for the mixture. The total ionic strength is given as calculated in the same in the way. There were several problems asked on diffusion coefficient, ionic strength, Ostwald dilution, as you know it is very important, and also transport number. Thank you very much. We'll continue.